experimental pharmacology. I am for human ethical animal research. If you ask me why, I have the answer. What is animal experimentation? Animal experimentation is the term used to explain the use of animals in experimentation, education, training, and research. So, drugs are commonly introduced in therapeutics after experimental evaluation. Animals should not be sacrificed just to acquire skills and techniques of experimentation. So, we can follow 4 R's, that is replacement, refinement, reduction, and rehabilitation, about which I'll be dealing in later slides. So, what's the importance of animal experimentation? Mainly, it is to alter physiology and also the cure of the disease, and to develop new drugs, vaccines, or procedures to prevent or treat diseases. So, to test the safety of products. So, why animals are used in biomedical research? The reasons are they are biologically, chemically, physiologically, and genetically similar to human beings. And they have comparatively shorter life cycle, and thus they can be studied throughout their whole lifespan or across several generations. So, some of the most commonly used animal for experimentally classified as rodents, non-rodents, and miscellaneous group. Under rodents, we have mouse, rat, guinea pig, gerbil, hamster. And non-rodents, we have rabbit, monkey, dog, cat, pig, miscellaneous. Under miscellaneous, we have frog, pigeon, zebra fish, etc. So, what all considerations should be taken when we are using animals for an experimentation? Ethics and animal use. We have to think over whether the animal is the best experimental system for an hypothesis to be tested, or is the problem under review worth solving, or can pain and discomfort be minimized for the animal. So, seeing into the 41, first legislation forbidding cruelty to animals was passed, and in 1824 and 1865, Society for Prevention of Cruelty to Animals, that is SPCA, was formed in England and USA, and in 1871, the British Association for the Advancement of Science published guidelines for animal experimentation, and in 1876, Prevention of Cruelty to Animals Act was passed in UK. And in India, in 1874, Bombay SPCA was formed, and in 1890, Act prevailing to cruelty to animals was implemented, and in 1960, the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals Act was passed, and CPCSEA, that is a Committee for the Purpose of Control and Supervision of Experiments on Animal, was formed. So, what is CPCSEA? Experimentation on animals in course of medical research and education is covered by provisions of the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals Act 1960, and Breeding and Experimentation on Animals Control and Supervision Rules of 1998, 2001, and 2006 framed under the Act. These are enforced by the Committee for the Purpose of Control and Supervision on Animals, a statutory body under the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals Act 1960. So, the main functions of CPCS are registration of establishments conducting animal experimentation or breeding of animals for this purpose, selection and appointment of nominees in the Institution Animal Ethical Committee, that is IAEC, of registered establishments, approval of animal house facilities on the basis of reports of inspection conducted by CPCSEA, permission for conducting experiments in wards of animals, recommendations for import of animals for use experiments, action against establishments in case of violation of any legal norm or stipulation. So, We'll be dealing with the principles, that is ethical principles, adopted by CPCSEA for use of animals in scientific experiments. Principle 1 is as experiments on animals, that is include experiments involving operation on animals, may be carried out for the purpose of advancement by new discovery of physiological knowledge or of knowledge to be useful for saving or prolonging human life or for alleviating suffering, or for significant gains in the well-being for the people of the country, or for combating any disease, whether of human being, animals or plants. Principle 2. Animals lowest on the phylogenetic scale, that is, with the least degree of sentience, which may give scientifically valid experiments, should be designed with the minimum number of animals to give statistically valid results at 95% level of confidence. Alternatives not involving animal testing should be given due and full consideration, and sound justification provided if alternative when available are not used. Principle 3. Proper use of animals in experiments and avoidance or minimization, when avoidance is not possible, of pain and suffering inflicted on experiments should be an issue of priority for research personnel, and unless the contrary is scientifically established, investigators should process on the basis that cause pain or suffering in human beings will also cause a sick. All scientific procedures adopted with animals that may cause more than momentary or slight pain and or suffering should be performed with appropriate sedation, analgesia or anesthesia. So, persons engaged in animal experimentation should have a moral responsibility for the welfare of animals after their use in experiments. Investigators are responsible for the aftercare of animals after experimentation and may be permitted to euthanize animal only in the following situations. That is, either when the animal is paralyzed and is not able to perform its natural functions, it becomes incapable of independent locomotion and or can no longer perceive the in an intelligible manner. During the course of experimental procedures, the animal has been left with a severe recurring pain, exhibits obvious signs of long-term extreme pain and suffering. In situations where non-termination of an animal experimented upon would be life-threatening to human beings or other animals. Cost of aftercare and or rehabilitation of animals post-experimentation are to be part of research cost and should be scaled per animal in positive correlation with the level of sentience of the animals. Principle 5. The living condition of animals should be appropriate for their species and contribute to their health and comfort. The housing, feeding and care of all should be given due importance. Biomedical purposes must be directed by a veterinarian or other scientist in a relevant discipline who is trained and experienced in the proper care, handling and use of species being maintained. In all circumstances, veterinary care should be provided as necessary. So, CPCSEA guidelines on specific aspects regarding the use of animals in scientific experiments are explained below. That is, there is a need to avoid or minimize pain and suffering inflicted on experimental animals, and proper care, handling and use of experimental animals, due importance, agricultural production research, procedures for approval of scientific experimentation on animals. So, what should be done for registration of such as? In terms of Rule 3 of the Breeding and Experiments on Animals under Control and Supervision 1998 as amended, shall carry on the business of breeding of animals or trade of animals for the purpose of experiments unless it is registered. In terms of Rule 4 of the Breeding and Experiments on Animals 1998 Control and Supervision Act, as amendment shall perform any experiment on animals unless it is registered with CPCSEA. Every such establishment shall performing experiments on animals or breeding of animals for use in experiments, if registered, is refused to it by CPCSEA. So the approval of animal house facilities in terms of Rule 5 of the Breeding and Experiments on Animals 1998 as amended, approval of animal house facilities by CPCSEA is required to be obtained for experiments are to be conducted. So the use of animals in experiments should be in accordance with in terms of Rule 9B of the Breeding and Experiments on Animals Control and Supervision 1998 as amended, which states that animal lowest on the phylogenetic scale which may give scientifically valid results should be given first consideration for any experimental procedure, and the experiment should be designed with the minimum number of animals to give statistically valid results at 95% degree of confidence. Replacement alternatives not involving experiments on animals should be given due and full consideration and sound just in case alternatives, though available, are not used. Moving on to the procedure of procurement of animals, in terms of Rule 10 of the Breeding and Experiments on Animals Control and Supervision as amended, an establishment shall acquire animals for experiments from registered breeders only. And in case of non-availability of animals from registered breeders, the animals may be procured from alternative legal sources. And in case the animal is procured from the order after taking written permission from the authority competent under the law for the time being enforced to give such permission, and replacement alternatives not involving experiments on animal should be given due and full consideration and sound justification must be provided in case alternatives, though available, are not used. And as per amendment of Rule 10, Experiments on Animal Control and Supervision 1998, this provision allows the establishment to import genetically defined animals with the permission of DGFT, that is Director General of Foreign Trade, in case such animals are not available with registered breeders or other legal sources within the country. The condition of non-availability will not apply to genetically defined or laboratory bred rats and mice. So, in terms of Rule 9C of the Breeding and Experimentation on Animals Control and Supervision 1998 as amended, personnel using the experimental animals shall be responsible for the welfare of the animals during their use in experiments, and the CPCSEA guidelines for laboratory animal facilities also spell out the baseline procedures to be followed when using animals in the course of scientific experimentation, including quarantine and animal care. So regarding the aftercare and rehabilitation of animals after use in scientific experiments, in terms of Rule 9C of the Breeding and Experiments on Animals Control and Supervision 1998 as amended, investigators shall be responsible for the aftercare and rehabilitation of the animals after experimentation. Cost of aftercare and rehabilitation of the animals after experimentation shall be made as part of the research cost and shall be scaled in positive correlation with the level of cost involved in such aftercare and rehabilitation of the animals. Rehabilitation of an animal after experimentation shall extend till the point the animal is able to resume a normal existence, providing a lump sum amount as cost for rehabilitation and care of such animals to cover its entire statistical expected lifespan, and the establishment undertaking experiments of duly signed and authorized animal welfare organization under the control of the committee may, on payment of lump sum amount, undertake rehabilitation of the. So moving on to the CPCSEA guidelines for laboratory animal facilities, mainly GLP has been mentioned, that is good laboratory practices for animal facilities, is intended to assure quality maintenance and welfare animals used in laboratory studies while conducting biomedical and behavioral research and testing of products. So the main goal is that the goal of these guidelines is to provide animals used in biomedical and behavioral research and testing with the basic objectives of providing specification that will enhance animal well-being, quality in the pursuit of advancement of biological knowledge that is relevant to human and animals. So GLP mainly includes veterinary care, animal procurement, quarantine, stabilization and separation, surveillance, diagnosis, treatment and control of diseases, animal care and technical personnel, personal hygiene, animal experimentation involving hazardous agents, multiple surgical procedures on a single animal, duration of experiments, physical restraint and physical facilities, location of animal facilities to laboratories, and the functional areas and facilities for sanitizing equipment and supplies. So experimental area and temperature, that's temperature and humidity control, ventilation, power and lighting, noise control. So GLP includes all these given points and its explanation as to how to conduct. And also related to animal husbandry, that is regarding the caging or housing system, sheltered outdoor housing, social environment, activity, food, bedding, water, sanitization, cleanliness, pest control, record keeping, emergency weekend, and holiday. And also they have mentioned some of the SOP, standard operating procedure guidelines, personnel and training, transport of laboratory animals regarding anesthesia and euthanasia. And the next one is IAEC, that is Institutional Animal Ethical Committee. It should constitute of a biology scientist, two scientists from different biology disciplines, and a veterinarian, a scientist in charge of animal facility of the establishment concerned, a scientist from outside the institute, a socially aware member, a representative or nominee of CPCS-EA, a specialist may be co-opted while reviewing special projects. So, some of the alternatives to animal experimentation are mentioned. Some of the in vitro techniques which can be taken up are organ cultures, tissue slices, primary cell cultures, established cell lines, stem cells, etc. And in silico, that is computer based, QSAR such as TopCat, Direct, TopSmart, Times, SS, etc. can be taken up. And invertebrate animals can be used, rapid developing vertebrates can be used, and micro dosing can be taken up, that is by using accelerator mass spectroscopy. And as I have mentioned in the first slide, the 4 R's which has to be followed are replacement, which mainly constitutes of two types, that is absolute replacement and relative replacement. And under absolute replacement, we have in silico or in vitro and cell lines, etc. Second is reduction, that is methods to reduce animal use. Refinement, that is decreased invasiveness, improved control of pain, appropriate anesthetic and analgesic regimes. And the fourth one is rehabilitation. So I would like to conclude by saying that Ayurveda also advocates the use of animals for experimentation, but at the same time we advocate ahimsa. The reference in Ashtanga Hridaya Sutrasthana, second chapter, in which Acharya has quoted that Atmavat Satadam Pashyedapi Kida Pipilikam. The experimentation of animal thus should be carried out only if it can be a native method. Thank you.